In this example, we are given that a current passing through a resistance R decreases uniformly 0 in a time interval T, and a total charge Q passes through the resistance. And we are required to find the total heat produced by the resistance in this process. Now, in this situation, we are given that at T equal to 0, there was some current. Let us consider the current was equals to I naught, say. We'll calculate the value of I naught later. And at time T equals to T, the current drops down to 0. It is given to us. And we plot a variation curve of current with the time. Here you can see, as it is given that it is uniformly decreasing to 0, in time T equals to 0 to T, then we can say at T equals to 0, the value of current was I naught. And from this graph, we can easily find out the function of current at a general time T. It can be written as the value of current here at a general time T, we can write as I naught minus I naught by T into T. This is a straight line function. We can write it by using mx plus c relation. And we are also given that the total amount of charge which passes through the resistance in this duration is Q. So we know that the area under the current time curve is the total charge. Then the total charge can be written as integration of I dt from 0 to t. And this area we can write as half I naught t. From this relation, we are getting the value of initial current I naught, which can be written as 2q by t. So we can substitute it here. The value of current we are getting 2q by t, 1 minus t by t. Now, as we know the current as a function of time, we can easily calculate the total heat produced from 0 to T time is, this heat we can write as current is time varying, we'll use integration of I square R dt from 0 to T. If we substitute the value of I over here, this will be integration of I square R. This can be written as, if we square it, it will be 4Q square R by T square, 1 minus T by T whole square dt within limits from 0 to T. Now, this is a constant term which can be taken out of the sign of integration, this 4q square r by t square. Then we will integrate by opening this term whole square. This will be 1 plus t square by t square minus 2t by t dt. Now, if we integrate, you can see what we are getting. It is 4q square r by t square. Integration of 1 is t plus integration of t square will be t cube by 3t square minus integration of t is t square by 2. Here 2 gets cancelled out, so this will be t square by t. And we apply limits from 0 to t. Now, if you substitute the limits over here, you can see what we'll get. In this relation, we'll be getting 4q square r by t square multiplied by, here this will be t plus this will be t by 3 minus, if you substitute t, this is t. Here t gets cancelled out and 1 t also gets cancelled out, and the final result we are getting is 4 by 3 q square r by t. This is the total amount of heat produced which we are calculating here, and that is the answer to this problem.